In the budget, you've estimated CGST collections to rise by 3 times in the next year. So for CGST, this year is around 2.2 lakh crore and it increases to 6 lakh crore in the next year. So my question is, what steps is the government taking to increase the mop-up by 3 times in the next financial year?
First of all, the CGST revenue this year is only for 8 months. First 3 months, there was no CGST. Out of the remaining 9 months, 1 month's revenue we are not going to get this year. It'll come in the next year. So that is why our CGST revenue is only for 8 months. That is number one. Number two, we are getting less inflow of CGST in the current year because we have allowed them the facility of utilizing the credit, input tax credit, lying in their ledger account on account of excise and service tax, which is as much as 1.4 lakh crore. That much of credit was lying in the ledger when the GST was introduced. Now that credit is being taken against CGST, and that is why the CGST revenues this year are less. But next year, this entire credit will get exhausted, and so we will hopefully get more CGST. So our estimates are very correct.
And so my next question is, you've cut excise duty on petrol and diesel, but you've implemented an infra cess. So net impact on prices is same. So my question is, are you willing to lower the excise duty in case oil prices move up?
Well, as far as the current change in today's budget, that is only nominal. From the viewpoint of consumer, there is nothing that changes. We have taken some part of the excise duty to cess, so that we allocate it for specific purpose of education and health. That is the purpose. But as when it comes to deciding about the future course of action, we will take suitable action if the need arises. We have done it in the past. Very recently, we reduced the excise duty on petrol and diesel by 2 rupees, if you remember. And that resulted into annual loss of 26,000 crore.
And sir, what is the price of oil prices assumed in the budget? Is that a range that you assumed, or is there a specific?
No, we haven't assumed anything in the budget. What we are assuming is that we will not have to do any alteration in the duty rate. While projecting the budget, we have not accounted for any decrease that we may have to do of the excise duty.
And sir, you've also increased customs duty on many products like mobile phones, television sets. So although the moral behind it is to promote making in India, but it is some sort of a burden on consumers now. So what went into this thinking?
Well, it's not really a burden now. You know, some of these items of electronic goods are used by relatively rich class of people, the smartphones and things like that. Feature phones are already made in India only now, so they are not going to become expensive. So our purpose is to drive all these smartphone manufacturers to come to India and manufacture it in India. That's the idea.
And sir, the finance minister has also said that cryptocurrency is not a legal tender in India, and the government will take certain steps to make sure that the gains made through cryptocurrency are not used for illegitimate purposes. So what sort of clampdown on bitcoins or other cryptocurrencies be expected in this year?
Well, it's subject of Department of Economic Affairs. I believe there is some committee which is working on this, and they will suggest suitable course of action for cryptocurrency. But one thing good about this budget announcement is that we have made it very clear that we don't support cryptocurrency, and if people want to invest, it is at their risk. We don't recognize it.
My last question to you is a clarification, not a question. The budget said that no deduction from total income will be allowed if tax returns are not filed on due date. So could you please elaborate?
Which announcement?
It said that no deductions from total income would be allowed if tax returns are not filed on due date. It's in chapter 4.
Okay. No, I think this provision is already there, you know. If the trust and political parties, they don't file their returns in time, then no deductions are allowed then. And what we have said in this budget is that trust so far, they had to, last budget we made it compulsory ki any donation more than 2,000 rupees will be received only in check, not by cash. But they had complete liberty to spend the entire money by cash, entire income by cash. And that's why some people used to misuse this provision. So now what we have said is ki all payments above 10,000 rupees will be made in check only. Otherwise, they'll be disallowed. If they make any payment by cash, the trust, then they will be in trouble.